Hi, this is Farmer Joe here. We're going to take a little walk down memory lane. We're doing Farm Simulator 15 today. And I want to take a look at Hobbs Farm version 8. This is a farm made for big kit road trains, industrial sized farming. You have inherited the Hobbs Farm estate from a distant cousin. Much of it was sold off over the last decade. Now it's time for you to build it back up. You still own the two forests and the BGA and just enough kit to get you started. What you do next is up to you. Okay, let's take just a quick run around Hobbs Farm. I'll show you the map. And then I'm probably going to start a Let's Play on this one too. I'll go back to 17 once in a while, but I miss my old mods like cosplay. And so the Stranger Things we've used over the years. So let's take a look around. Okay, as for equipment, well, let's start this. Let's put this on single and let's turn this off. Now, we have very little to get started. We have this Case Combine and Hobbs Farm version 8 trailer. We have the Hobbs Farm estate cab, and we have this tractor, which was what we're going to use to run around with today because we don't have that much money. Okay, this obviously is your shop. Yeah, it's Steve did a different kind of shop than most have. Back here is your garden center. And the one thing he does differently is this is where you sell your equipment. Hobbs, Keith's Parts. Also down here, we have the slaughterhouse, where you bring your little animals. And it's what I've affectionately heard it called Meat World. Here we have Toons, which as you can see from the sign, buys beef, pork, eggs, wool, and potatoes. And this is a multi-fruit map. We have carrots and onions. We have a big grass field over to the left, which we don't own. It's a monstrous field. Excuse me. And it's set up so that cosplay will actually recognize it, which is a good thing. Now going across, we own another fields down on this level. These are some of the fields we have to buy, but over here, head out over this way. This is one of the two forests we own. This one has a log sell point, a train. And also, number 415, we also have the lake. There's another sell point for logs. Just dump them in a lake and have fun. Now there are two ways up to the top. We'll go the regular way. if I don't fall in the lake. Let's head back to take a shortcut. Head back to the shop. I'll show you the main route and the two fields we own. You gotta realize these are massive fields. Everything on this farm is massive except for pretty much field 11, which is one of the two fields we own. Straight out of the gate from the shop, we go up this hill. Follow us around, it'll bring us right to the main farm, but first the BGA. All these doors are all operable. You have these four massive silo clamps. On this side, and two smaller ones up here. Heading out this way, we come to this is the massive field we own. It's planted currently with canola. Field one. Heading over this way. Excuse me one second. Okay, hopefully I'm back. Yes, I am. Okay. Head down here. Which is the other side of our forest. We have Wolf Inc., which is where we're going to sell our potatoes and sugar beets, right over here. This is potatoes, got a nice scale. And I thought for a second there the sugar beets were on that side. Oh well. Haters gonna hate potatoes. This is our sell point for potatoes. Got another gasoline. No sugar beets around here someplace. Sugar beets, where are you? There's our sugar beets. Okay, I knew they had to be here somewhere. So I'm going for sugar beets. Out this way. The have a sell points for grain. Oh, we have the fire department. Hobbs Area Fire Department. You actually can go in and out of it. Download some fire trucks. Here we have four more silage pits, I guess you call them, or plants. These are the small silage. Spot for placeables. Grain elevator. Another sell point. Sure you own all the grain elevator sell point. Windmill. Another wolf. Sell point. It's grain or onion. I really don't know. Looks like grain. More open area for placeables. The heating plant for wood chips. Obviously. Another gas station. Stevie Hopgoblin worked on this map for a long time. He's trying to bring it out for 17, which is murder without crossplay. You see the size of these fields. These are the small fields. Take a look on the map where we are now. These are some of the small fields. Now, why I'm thinking it this way is we're coming up on the other forest we own. And this has some really nice touches to it. Take the side entrance. I know this is a slow way to go with this tractor, but what can you do? We have this nice house, garage, house, and we have our wood chip storage. If you play 15, no, we're familiar with this one. This was a nice one. Opens up, dump your wood chips in there. Also, we have a spot to sell manure and slurry. Give us more money. All these trees to cut down and chip. There's birds chirping in the background. Also, we have a loading trench for logs. Walk the truck down here. Makes it easy to load stuff in them. Drive your log straight out. That pretty much is everything on the map. side of our farm. Take a look at our livestock area. Up on the little field we own, which isn't that little. This is field 11, the other field we own. Not quite as massive as one. Still pretty big. Here we have our loading area for loading our trucks with grain. We got two of them. Silage pit, storing silage, grass, and chaff. Here we have our loading spots for potatoes. Sugar beets, carrots. Whoever did this, boy, it's spectacular. Well, I always loved it. I don't know if he did it or one of the other guys put this map together or whether they found this mod, but it's done very well. We have that tote board. Got a board for our grains down here. Let us know how much we have. There's our other side for loading. Load out of bolting. The scale. Twin dump points. Another board here, grains, another complete board here, and where we dump our earth fruit and silage chaff straw. This is straw, forage, silage, and chaff. Obviously, it's going to match the other side. Potatoes. Sugar beets. Onions are here. And carrots here. Here we have the storage. We looked at before. All these doors open and close. Our seed, gasoline, fertilizer here. We have this nice rack for headers. More scales. Lo and behold, another silage clamp. On the left, here we have our cow area. Doors obviously open and close. Here's where we pick up our straw that we dumped way over there. It must be a very good auger system. Manure, slurry, obviously. Feed for cattle, along with the feed that's inside. Here we have Now he takes. See what animals we have. Fattening area. Pigs and beef. Okay, one's pigs, one's beef. Not sure which is which yet. I don't hear any wing sounds or pig sounds. He thankfully calmed them down. When this mod first came out, it deafened. You could get within 50 feet of these things without going deaf. Storage area for bales, another one of our trailers, and here's our sheep area. Water grass, and a pallet moving system for our wool bales. And that's pretty much the farm. So I'm going to continue 17, like I said, but I'm going to be doing a lot on this one. I've always liked Hobbs Farm, and pull this over to the side here, my office, shut it down. I hope you enjoyed Hobbs Farm. I hope you'll watch the Let's Play on it. I'll probably be doing more of this than 17 until more script mods come out for like cosplay and things like that. And there's only so much you can do with Goldcrest. And until we get some decent maps, some other maps, there's some good ones out there. I'll probably be hitting this a lot more. So I hope you'll join me. And like always, see you next time.